But the thing with Call of Duty, which makes me like so aggressive, is like, you know, there's like a 12-year-old kid shooting you in the head. I don't even know which genre it was. Trancy, techno, bass, house. Yeah, we had a clan. But I was also really bad at that, so...
So then you decide to be a producer.
Yeah, I was like, what's another thing I'm really bad at? Let's just try that. Game on.
Game hard. Hey guys, and welcome to another Game On, Game Hard. Today, we're here with Mr. Hard Driver himself.
What's up?
How are you doing, buddy?
Pretty good, but I'm a bit nervous because I'm really bad at gaming, so...
But I chose a racing game for you because... Hard Driver. You know?
God damn.
But today we're playing Crash Team Racing, Nitro Fueled, and it's a little bit like Mario Kart.
It's like from Crash Bandicoot, right?
Crash Bandicoot, yeah.
You played before?
Played that as a kid.
Oh, yeah. Well, bringing back the old school.
Bad at that as well.
All right, so we're gonna choose a character and get our thingies.
Okay.
Can I swear?
Yeah, definitely.
It's gonna happen.
I swear all the time.
So if I say my balls, no problem.
Yeah, it's just gonna be.
2 hours later.
Many, many eternities later.
1 eternity later.
Do you game a lot?
No, I stopped my PlayStation Online subscription a few weeks ago. I used to play Call of Duty, like the first week it's fun, because then the game is all new, but then after weeks I was like, I'm only getting like stressed out.
Yeah, getting pwned.
And my girlfriend was like, she heard me upstairs, because my PlayStation is in the studio, and she was like, oh man, you should really stop gaming, because it's not good for your heart.
All right.
Oh yeah, so
Go! Ah, oh, bastard. Okay, so it's like Mario Kart, you have like little boxes and stuff and you can like shoot things, but how? So you usually play like PlayStation and stuff? And you...
Yeah, when I was a teenager, a long time ago, I used to play Medal of Honor.
Ah, yeah, that's fun.
With like some classmates. Yeah, we had a clan. But I was also really bad at that, so it didn't take very long.
So then you decide to be a producer?
Yeah, I was like, what's another thing I'm really bad at? Let's just try that. And I also tried to be a professional athlete.
Really? What'd you play?
No.
I don't know.
No. Yeah, so and I played GTA a lot.
Which one?
Apple!
I always have a discussion with Denza, because I play GTA, but I just steal a car and then I just drive around and I don't do anything.
That's the point of the game.
Yeah, but I'm just driving on the road.
Are you like following the
And he's like, yeah man, but you should play the career mode, and I'm just like, no man, I want to relax and just drive around.
Beat up some people, or are you just gonna like follow
the... Yeah, like I shoot some grandmas and stuff. I always go to the area where the hookers are. And I steal the money of the hookers. Oh, I'm third.
Yeah. GG. Good game.
It's a lot better now.
All
right,
best of three, I guess, you know? So the winner takes it all.
Or nothing.
All or nothing.
Change level.
Wamp. Yeah, so I play GTA, but only more to relax. Like I would steal an airplane and just fly around and then crash the airplane in the sea.
That's fun. Like that's what I did as well. Find the best cars, go to the army base and steal the tanks and stuff. Yeah. Love it.
Really? Well, this is kind of fun.
It's pretty cool.
Maybe a stupid question, but this is not online or anything.
Yeah, yeah. It's gonna be online.
No, but this game. Whoa. Jill is choking on a croissant. But the thing with Call of Duty, which makes me like so aggressive, is like, you know, there's like a 12-year-old kid shooting you in the head all the time. And I'm just really bad at it. It's just the fact that it's like real people shooting you.
I play on the computer and like sometimes I just smash people. Like, I couldn't play it. I can't. I don't even know how you can aim with these things. Like my son plays Fortnite and he's just like.
Yeah, but they are like real pros.
Yeah, but now he's six or something.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, that's cool. Good to know.
But yeah, it's not good for the heart, I think.
No. And what do you do like now to relax?
Go to the gym. Which is not really relaxing, but it's relaxing the mind.
Ah, okay, that's good.
And just watching series.
Ah, which one are you watching now?
I've started watching The Wire again, which is like a pretty old series. But yeah, and then I have to watch The Witcher.
Ah!
Because we are making a bootleg.
Ah, explain.
Yeah, for the Elite, for Reverse.
Yeah.
And yeah, I haven't even seen the
kids watching
series.
Ah, dude, the series is awesome. Like, the game is really cool as well. It's like really.
Are you shooting me?
No, I don't. Oh, I have the bomb. Ah, so we're gonna have to hear the premiere on Reverse.
Yep. Okay. Like, I don't know when this is going live, but like,
you're watching this Reverse is like way back.
Yeah, like Reverse, actually, from now it's in a few days. So in between all the studio work, I just spent my time gaming.
Yeah, but I hear you also like do audio work for intros and stuff, shows.
Yep. Like, been doing that for maybe 7 years, I think.
Oh wow, that's cool.
So all the intros and the trailer, and I used to do it alone, but now I'm doing it with Laurent, who was part of Unloaders,
oh, yeah,
for those who remember. Because I yeah, wasn't doable alone,
no,
with all the other stuff.
Oh, wow. So,
and like, I used to do that for more events, but like, now I'm only doing Reverse, because that's like the baby, you know? And Ryan is actually writing all the texts, for those who know.
Yeah, I help you.
No, hey! Right.
I'm first again. I just keep talking to you and then I just win, you know?
Yeah, cool.
Okay, one more try. We'll do a hard level. So yeah, you're like busy.
Yeah.
Public Enemies, The Elite, Hard Driver.
Yeah. Some other secret projects.
Poof, how do you even find time?
My thing is, I work really fast, I think. I'm always working on a lot of different stuff. Like, on one day I can work on like maybe 4 different tracks for different projects. So when I'm like stuck with one thing, I'm not gonna spend like 3 days trying to find the right thing. So I'll just switch, and I think that keeps the creativity
flowing. Let's play Bingo Canyon.
I'm good at like deciding like, yeah, this is good, no, let's not overcomplicate things, yeah. Let's not keep searching for.
Yeah, I think that's like a problem with a lot of producers, where they just think too much, you know, and you just have to make a decision, just do it.
Yeah, but it's also, yeah, like, you want to do something new, but also not too weird, and you have your own sound, but you want to keep evolving, and it's always finding the balance, which is difficult.
Yeah, I can imagine.
But the thing is, I'm pretty good at technical stuff, so when I have a sound in mind, then I know pretty fast how to make it, so that's maybe an advantage.
How long have you been producing for?
Since I was 12.
And you are?
31. But I wouldn't say the first 3 years were called producing. I don't even know which genre it was. Maybe like trancey, techno, bass, house.
Okay, but was, like, was that like on a Commodore or something? Or was that?
No, that was like a Pentium 3, or what's it called?
Ah, yes. One song and your hard drive's filled.
Yeah, and that was my hard drive. Oh, and I remember using Nitro, fuck. I remember using Magic's Music Maker.
Oh yeah.
Which had like all these pre-made loops and shit. Whoa, this is really bad.
Keep talking. Second.
Yeah, this helps you.
Oh, I'm stuck in a waterfall. God damn it. Oh yeah, it was Trolley Mike. Hey, crack open a beer.
I heard, maybe you can confirm, if you say throw another shrimp on the barbie, the Australians don't like that.
Chuck another shrimp on the barbie.
That's like,
why would
they like it?
Why would you even eat shrimps?
Yeah, but they don't really say that, right?
So chuck another prawn on the barbie, mate. I don't really know, actually, because
chuck a cold one with the boys?
Chuck a cold one with the boys, chuck a hack.
Hey, in second.
Chuck a mad hack, boys.
Let's screw a kangaroo, mate.
But who told you that?
Who's first?
Oh, I'm sixth. You're first. Have you been to Australia before?
Yeah, I think 7 times.
Oh, wow. Cool.
Maybe going again this year.
Yeah, it's like the DJ life really brings you, like, you know, you can see a lot of places. You know?
Yeah.
What's the best place you've ever been to?
DJing?
Yeah.
I'd say Chile.
Chile?
Yeah.
Because it's a beautiful country, or because?
Oh, the crowd.
Crowd, yeah. Yeah.
But really sick. Guess who's first?
You.
Fucking faggot. But I still lost.
You still lost.
The championship.
You're the winner. You're the winner in my mind. All right, guys.
This was it?
It was, yeah. It was really like...
Pretty cool.
Time passed like no time.
Yeah, such good friends.
Yeah, it's good. It's good. Good times. Frick.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for coming.
Should I say like I've been beaten?
You can say that. No, like DJs, if they win once, they would have been the whole time. You can't win against me. So, this was another episode of Game On Game Hard with Hard Driver. And we played Crash Bandicoot Crash Team Racing or something.
It's sponsored.
Sponsored by?
By, no. It's about time.
Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this new episode of Game On Game Hard with Mr. Hard Driver. Let us know in the comments what you thought and which artist you want to see next. And then maybe we can make it happen.
Thanks for having me.
See ya.
See you next time.
Bye-bye.